So hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Physical Education for Reviewer third quarter for second semester. So kung meron kayong test para sa third quarter sa PE nyo, so this could be a good reviewer for you. So our discussion is all about canoeing, kayaking, snorkeling, and scuba diving. And these four activities are considered as recreational activities. Recreation refers to all those activities that people choose to do to refresh their bodies and minds and make their leisure time more interesting and enjoyable. So aside from snorkeling, kayaking, and other water activities, we also have an example of recreation activities are walking, swimming, meditation, reading, playing games, and dancing. Number one, we have running, hiking, yoga, biking, kite flying, morning walk. So ito lang yung mga ilang example na nilagay ko dito sa recreational activities. Pero napakarami pang ibang recreational activities kagaya na lang ng pagbabasketball, pagbaballeyball, o basta lahat ng ginagamitan ng galaw ng katawan, pwede siyang tawagin recreational activities. Kahit nga yung pag-gardening nyo, yung pagdidilig nyo sa labas ng bahay nyo. Kahit yung mga mamatapa nyo, yung mga plantito, plantitas na nag-garden dyan, nag-ahalaman, yan, parte yan ng recreational activities. Pero ang focus natin ngayon is yung mga ginagawa sa tubig ng mga recreational activities. Kagaya na lang ng canoeing. Canoeing is an activity which involves paddling a canoe with a single bladed paddle. So yung canoe, ito yung bangka na sinasakyan nila. So na-mention din na single bladed paddle. So isang ano lang siya. Kasi di ba merong sagwan na dalawa, meron sa kabila, meron sa kanan, meron sa kaliwa, pang isahang tao. So mamaya makikita niyo yan. Health benefits of canoeing. Both activities improve cardiovascular fitness as well as increase in muscle strength, especially in the back, arms, shoulders, and chest. Regular canoeing and kayaking can improve torso and leg strength as the vessel is often maneuvered by rotating the torso and using leg pressure. So speaking of kayaking, mamaya, i-discuss natin kung ano ba yung kayaking at yung mga differences nilang dalawa. Kasi almost magkamukha lang talaga yung canoeing and kayaking. A brief history of canoeing. The first ever canoes were made and developed in thousands of years by the Native Americans. These canoes were made out of large tree trunks by shaping them and making them hollow. It was also made sure that they were strong enough to travel from one island to another. So bago pa maging recreational activities yung canoeing o gawing libangan ng mga tao ngayon, pagkapag nag-vacation, ginagawa na rin to ng mga Native Americans ng mga sinaunang panahon pa. Pero ang kanilang goal is to travel and then to find something interesting or something valuable na pwedeng mag-benefit sa kanila. Pwede silang mangaso, di ba? Paanong mangaso? Mangisda, yan, mga ganyan. Hanap sila ng pagkain sa ibang isla, mga ganon. Where did canoe originate? Constructed between 8200 and 7600 before Christ and found in the Netherlands. The Peace Canoe may be the oldest known canoe. Excavations in Denmark revealed the use of dugouts and paddles during the Ertibjot period. 5300 to 3050 before Christ, one of the oldest canoes in the world is the Dufuna Canoe in Nigeria. So speaking of kayaking, ito na yung kayaking. Kayaking is the use of kayak for moving over water. It is distinguished from canoeing by the sitting position of the paddler and the number of blades on the paddle. A kayak is a low to the water canoe-like boat in which the paddler sits facing forward, legs in front, using a double-bladed paddle to pull front to back on one side and then the other in rotation. Most kayaks have closed decks, although sit on top and inflatable kayaks are growing in popularity as well. So ito yung picture ng kayaking. So kung makikita nyo, single lang yung tao. And then, yung blade niya, magkabila, kanan pati sa kaliwa, meron. Yung hawak niyang sagwan. So, origin of kayaking. The first kayaks were rudimentary designs built approximately 5,000 years ago by the Inuit and Aleut people to travel swiftly across the water. Located in the Arctic North America, these tribes would construct the kayaks out of water types of material they could find, including animal skins, bones, and wood. A kayak is a small narrow watercraft which is typically propelled by means of a double-bladed paddle. So the word kayak originates from the Greenlandic word kajak. So take note guys na pwede rin kayong gumawa ng sarili nyong research about canoeing, kayaking, scuba diving, and snorkeling para naman mas ma-expand yung kaalaman nyo at ma-discover nyo pa kung ano pa ba yung mga ibang information about dito. So ito lang yung mga nilagay kong information nyo. Yung sa tingin kong mga mahalaga nang sa ganun, medyo hindi siya ganun kadami at halo-halo na. So medyo masakit na sa ulo yun. So, difference between kayaking and canoeing. In a kayak, the paddler is seated and uses a double-bladed paddle, pulling the blade through the water on alternate sides to move forward. In a canoe, the paddler kneels and uses a single-bladed paddle to propel the boat forward. So, ang dali lang naman ma-distinguish o makilala yung mga yung pagkakaiba nitong dalawang to. Unang-una sa bangka, yung shape ng bangka nila. Ayan o. Para siyang patusok na medyo payat. Tapos, isa lang yung upuan talaga eh. Kayak with double blade paddle. And then yung sagwan, double eh. Dalawa. Dalawa yung blade niya. Sa canoe, isa lang. Tapos, pwedeng umupo dalawa. And then, makikita nyo rin iba yung shape ng bangka. So, ito. Nakuha ko sa sketchplanations.com. What's the difference between kayak and canoe? Yeah, usually opens in the center except sits on seated with legs out in front, double bladed paddle for alternate strokes. That's kayak. And then canoe, sat with legs tucked or kneeling, usually open full length, single bladed paddle. And then ito pa, canoe versus kayak, know the difference. Yan, single blade paddles, multiple people, more storage for gear, canoe, kayak, double blade paddle, speed and agility, lighter and easy to store, 6.19 inch length, 16.7 inch length, yan, basahin nyo na lang. Okay, moving on, we have snorkeling. Snorkeling is an activity in which a person swims using a mask. Snorkel and swimming aids such as fins but without using self-contained underwater breathing apparatus, which is scuba. So ito siya. So maraming gumagawa nito, 'di ba? Kahit sa mga swimming pool may mga nagaganyan ganyan kunyari eh. Pero mas maganda siya sa dagat, no? May mga gumagawa nitong iilan. Lalo na kapag vacation. So snorkeling equipments, we have mask and snorkel. Yung panghinga is snorkel ang tawag dyan. And then yung sa paa, yung nilalagay ang tawag dyan, fins. F-I-N-S. History of snorkeling. The very earliest snorkelers were thought to be sponge farmers on the Grecian island or Crete some 5,000 years ago who used hollow tubes to allow breathing while they kept their faces in the water to free dive for sponges. So, nag-research ako sa 20th century ng mga snorkeling na itsura. So, gantong-ganto siya. Buong mukha mo may parang glass. Scuba diving. The acronym SCUBA stands for Self-Contained Underwater Breathing Apparatus, a sport or activity in which you swim underwater using an air tank and a special breathing machine that you strap on your back. So kapag scuba diving, it's more professional kasi kompleto yung mga gamit niya. Meron pa siyang oxygen and basta kompleto pati suit eh. Sa snorkeling kasi kahit nakaubad ka, pwede. Dito, hindi ko sure kung pwede dito pero pwede naman siguro kahit nakaubad ka. Pero mas safe, mas ligtas talaga kung nakasuot kompleto. So mamaya malalaman natin yung differences nilang dalawa. madaling-madali lang din naman ma-spot yung difference ng dalaw. Who invented scuba diving? Jacques Yves Costa or Jacques Costa and Emil Gagnon together invented the modern demand regulator used in underwater diving. Their invention allowed for the equipment known as the aqualung or self-contained underwater breathing apparatus, which is scuba, enabling safer and deeper dives. So don't forget na yung acronym na scuba, ang full name yan is self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. And yung naka-invent yan is si Jacques Yves Costa. Most of the time, ang mas lumalabas sa test si Jacques Yves Costa at hindi na nasasama si Emil Gagnon. Equipments of scuba diving. So yan, have a look. Meron tayong ACD, yung parang sa likod, and then regulator, octopus, instruments, computer, light, knife, tank, fins, snorkel, mask, dive suit. Ayan, basic scuba diving equipment, BCD vest, regulator, alternate air, fins, body skin, swim shoes, submersible pressure and depth gauge, BCD or buoyancy control device, yan ang meaning niya, mask and snorkel. So guys, huwag niyong kakalimutan mag-research din about dito sa mga equipment ng scuba diving nyo. Kasi hindi tayo masyadong detailed dito sa discussion natin about sa mga equipments kasi masyadong mahaba na yun. So, kayo nang bahala mag-research, no? Madami naman kayo makikita sa internet. Lalong-lalo na yung buoyancy control device yan. Isa yan sa mga lumalabas sa exam. Magbasa-basa lang kayo. So, speaking of scuba diving, let's determine the difference between snorkeling and scuba diving. The key difference between these two activities is how deep you go into the water. Snorkelers savor the underwater geography while floating close to the surface. While scuba divers stay underwater longer, they can maneuver exploring coral reefs and marine life. At yung pinagkaiba rin yan is siguro yung presyo. Alam ko kasi kapag scuba diving, may bayad yung mga ganyan. And then yung snorkeling, pwede mong gawin yan na sa'yo. Kailangan mo lang ng equipment. So kung may nagbabalak ng ganito sa vacation, pang mga mayayaman lang kasi gumagawa nito eh. History of scuba diving. Scuba diving is a sport that had its humble beginnings in ancient times. In early Greece and Rome, people used to swim or dive while holding their breath or by using makeshift breathing apparatus like hollow plant stems. This was commonly practiced during combat or while gathering food and materials from the ocean. So ito yung mga sinaunang scuba divers at yung equipment. So familiar sa inyo kasi nakikita nyo yan sa mga palabas na yung mga sinaunang palabas kung saan merong mga dagat-dagat, barko, yung Pirates in Caribbean ba yun? Hindi ako nagkakamali. So thank you for watching. Dito na natatapos ang ating discussion about snorkeling, scuba diving, kayaking, and canoeing. So, kung meron pa kayong gustong idagdag na information, don't forget to comment down below. Huwag kayong mahiya mag-comment kung meron kayong tanong, gustong idagdag na information about sa ating discussion. And if you find this video very helpful, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And i-share nyo dito sa mga friends nyo na nangangailangan, sa mga classmates nyo na gustong mag-review. Pero actually guys, hindi pa talaga tayo tapos kasi meron pa tayong dagdag na tatlong question. Meron akong na-ready yung tatlong question na pwedeng lumabas sa exam. So ito, what tide is the best for snorkeling? The answer is low tide. So low tide ang sagot po dito sa number 1. Oops, see, next tayo. So number 2, what aquatic activity was mentioned by Aristotle in his Parts of Animals in which he refers to divers using instruments for respiration resembling the elephant's trunk. So alam ko hindi natin na-discuss to, pero gusto ko lang siyang ilagay dito na tanong kasi this could be a guide for your test for your third quarter examination. So ang sagot dito is walang iba kundi snorkeling, letter C. Okay, moving on. Scuba stands for A, self-contained understanding the breathing air, B, self-conscious underwater breathing apparatus, or C, self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. So the answer is very obvious, letter C. So thank you for watching. If you find this video very helpful, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And guys, I encourage you to do more research about these recreational activities such as scuba diving, snorkeling, canoeing, kayaking. And guys, huwag din tayo puro higa lang sa bahay. Gawa rin tayo ng ating recreational activities kagaya ng jogging. Galaw-galaw din, mas maganda rin na nagpa-function yung katawan natin, no? So, hindi lang kayo nagkaroon ng knowledge about dito, nagkaroon din kayo ng parang motivation na makapag-exercise na nga. Simulan ko na kaya, di ba? Imagine being the best version of yourself, di ba? So, dito na nagtatapos ang ating video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you learn anything today. And if you find this video very helpful, please don't forget to